Hi, welcome to Learn Image Processing using MATLAB for Beginners. In this lecture, we talk about histogram equalization and we try to implement it without using the inbuilt function. So as discussed before, histogram is a graph showing the number of pixels in an image at each different intensity value found in that image. So if I have an 8-bit image, it will have 256 intensity values, and by the histogram we are able to plot the number of pixels at each and every given intensity value. Now to actually calculate and perform the histogram equalization, we first make a table like this. In the first column we have the gray level. So we right now have a 3-bit image which will have 8 levels, so 0 to 7 are the intensity values that we have, and the number of pixels in each of every intensity value is given next to it. So then we find out the PDF, which is the probability density function of each and every intensity level. For this, we have the number of pixels in that particular intensity level and divide it by the total number of pixels. So 790 divided by 4096 gives us 0.19. 1023 divided by 4096 will give us 0.25, and so on. Once the PDF is calculated, we find out the CDF, which is the cumulative density function. So the cumulative density function, this is copied here. To obtain this, we just add this 0.25 with 0.19 and we get this. To get this, 0.44 plus 0.21 and we get this. So similarly, when we keep adding, ultimately, the sum of all PDFs is always 1, so that is why the last would always be 1. Then we multiply this with the number of intensity values minus 1. So we have 8 intensity values, so we'll multiply this with 7 and find out the corresponding values. Once this is got, we need to quantize this because our intensities will always be whole numbers. So we round it off to the nearest possible integer. Once this is done, now I know that this is my final histogram after equalization. Here, 0, you can see here, is not assigned any pixel. 1 is assigned all the pixels of 0. So this would be 790. 3 is assigned the pixels of 1 and it's getting 1023. 5 is getting this many. 6 is getting both the pixels of 3 and 4. So this plus this would be assigned to 6. And 7 would be assigned all the pixels from 5, 6 and 7. So this is how my equalized histogram will look like. You can see we had no assignments for 2, 0, 2, 4. And the rest of the assignments are as shown here. So now we try to implement this using MATLAB. So for this I'll just make a new script. I will read my cameraman image. The number of rows would be stored in R. The number of columns would be stored in C. AH would store the final value. So assign it U int 8, unsigned integers of all zeros, and the size would be the same as the input size. So number of rows and columns would be the same. Total number of pixels would be the number of rows into the number of columns. Now I have a variable called frequency. I will make it a column vector. And this will have 256 values because I have 256 intensity levels. I make another column vector for PDF. So I'm basically trying to replicate all the columns that we had in the table shown before. This is to store the intermediate result. We will need some extra variables. Now once this is done, I will iterate between the rows and then between the columns. Value would be the intensity value of a particular pixel indexed by I and j. Now we remember that our indexing in the arrays or row matrices are start from 1, whereas our intensity values start from 0. So that is why we will have to index accordingly. So my first value of f would store the value of intensity 0 and I add it to the previous value. For the same value, now I can calculate the PDF of that particular row. So PDF would be F value plus 1 divided by the total number of pixels. This is what we did in the table too. And I end these loops. Now I make another variable sum just to accumulate these sums. And L is the intensity value I would like to multiply with. So actually it is 256, but since we multiply with L minus 1, that is why I have taken it to be 255. Then again we iterate through the entire column matrix. So here I have taken the sum of all the frequencies and then I have assigned this variable to the sum. Basically, for that particular row in the column matrix, we are assigning the CDF value. Now I have the final output stored in out, and this will be the rounding value, the last column of our table. So we multiply the CDF with capital L, which is actually L minus 1. Once this is done, I end my loop. Now my image, again, like I said, the intensity values range from 0 to 255, whereas our indexing ranges from 1 to 256. So we have to take care of that. So again, we iterate through the image and we assign final values accordingly. Now, just to see how it looks like, you can see I am show this. I will also use the inbuilt function to equalize the image. So I can say hist eq a, and I will also show this in a new figure. So my the figure 2 will have the inbuilt function and figure 1 would be our function. So let's see how it runs. So you can see figure 1 is our function and figure 2 is the inbuilt function, and they look very similar. So this is how we implement histogram equalization using our own function. I'll see you in the next class. Thank you.